12 o'clock on a Wednesday, and this is the Wizard Product Review. I'm Dave.
I'm Greg.
And on this week's show...
A bit half-assed there. On this week's show, it's rapidly becoming the Richard Sanders show.
You've got so much going out. Coming out in one go. It must be lecture tour time.
It's like buses, you know. You wait absolutely ages for a Richard Sanders thing to come along, and then 10 come along at once. This one is remarkable. Transform your Sharpie marker into a secret weapon.
John, can we get it off the sticks?
Let's do this.
We're going to get it off the sticks, first of all. And I'm going to go through. Craig, say stop.
Stop.
Absolutely perfect. Thank you very much. No, remember that card? You can show it to the camera as well.
Boom. Got it, yeah.
And John, say stop.
Stop.
And can you remember that card as well?
Yep.
Just remember that one. That'll be perfect. And that one can go back as well. But remember your cards, guys. Mm-hmm. Now, I'm going to use our old friend, the Sharpie marker right now, the David Beckham pen. And you're going to see this happen right in front of you. First of all, Craig, you're thinking of a card.
I'm thinking of a card.
What was your card?
It was the Six of Clubs.
And if you watch, just watch that Six of Clubs. If I snap, you see, actually changes. The ink on the Sharpie actually changes on both sides right there. But that's not it, you see. Hold your hand out. Just keep your hand just there, like a table. That's another card. Just going to put that there. If I take the Sharpie marker, which is now changed to Six of Clubs, if I just give it a tap and you turn over that card, turn it over. See,
Six
that changes.
Clubs.
It has that effect on everything, you see. But you're thinking of a card as well, aren't you, John?
Yeah.
And we've got the Sharpie marker once again with the Six of Clubs on there. And just think of your card right now, John, and watch closely. The ink changes once again. Now this is the Ace of Hearts. And on the other side, we've got the Six of Clubs. And you can check that, Craig. That's printed on there.
That's awesome.
That's remarkable.
That's remarkable.
Now, I kind of have to backtrack a little bit, don't I? Because it is kind of like a paddle trick.
Yeah, hang on. That's a very good
point. I thought I'd say this before... You know, the guys on the forum go, oh, you said this last week.
Yeah. So why is this acceptable?
Because it's organic. It's a normal object.
Okay,
and the move you're doing with it is irrelevant as long as it doesn't look like a toy shop thing, as far as I'm concerned.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't know why. I still will say this. I know guys have gone on the forums and said, yeah, they agree with me. And some said they agree with you. But the thing is, this looks like a normal object.
Yes,
it was the object I didn't like.
It looked like
a kid's magic set toy. It looked like a magic set toy.
And I think, to
this
be honest,
doesn't look like a magic
Turbo
set.
Stick, I think people are divided right down the middle, and that's
and
fair enough.
What I don't get is why Richard Sanders has got like these two things, and he's going, oh, I've got Turbo Stick and I've got Remarkable. Are you even bothered with Turbo Stick?
Oh,
that's,
come on.
That's what I think.
Turbo Stick has grown on me, I must admit.
Thank you, John.
Turbo Stick's grown on him. Have you been out and worked it? No, he hasn't, no.
But I like playing with it.
Well, there you go. There's
he
a quote for there is a product
there you
review.
Go. That's an awesome quote.
John likes John playing Farr, with it,
I
apparently.
Like now, here's the thing about this. Sharpie markers have been around forever with a playing card written on one side.
It's very hot in the UK today.
Everybody knows that playing, they've been around forever. But every time I've seen one of these before, they've just been sold as a pen with no instructions and it's just been printed with the name of a card. What this has is you get a couple of custom-made pens. You've got Richard's routine.
And it's been made by Sharpie as well.
Yes, it has.
I think that's worth saying.
It's not like somebody's just gone and wrote Ace of Hearts on it. It's been custom printed by Sharpie. And it comes with the full routine, a couple of different routines, and all the full instructions, full performance videos. And the thing about this is it's an instant reset. You can literally, you carry your pen around with you anyway. All you need to do is put these in your pocket. You do the routine. As soon as you put your pen away, you're instantly reset, ready to go again.
And you can just do one card and it changes.
Yeah, but I think, to be honest,
I like the routine. I haven't been out and worked it.
The routine's
but
great.
But I do like that with the card. They pick cards and then the pen is used to change the cards. The misdirection's bulletproof then for what you've got to do.
Well, I think anybody that knows my work knows I do a lot with Sharpies. I do an awful lot with Sharpies. And I think this is golden. You know, I mean, wasn't it Di Vernon that said that if you know one card. If you know one card force, but 100 ways to reveal the card, you got 100 tricks. But if you know 100 card forces and one,
I'd hate to see that show. But yeah, there you go.
No, boom, boom, boom. But this is what this is. This is just another card revelation. It's a revelation of two cards. If you carry a pack of cards around with you, there is a very good chance you're going to carry a Sharpie around with you if you're a working professional. And if you're carrying a Sharpie around with you, why not carry this around with you as well? And then you're set to do this anytime, anywhere. Instant reset, angle proof, visual difference. And I tell you what, you know,
use it anytime as well. Use it in a multiple card find routine if you wanted
great.
To, just as a different card revelation.
Do you ever get this? You go over to a table that have not really seen magic before and you go, hey, pick a card. And they go, I've seen that one.
Yeah.
And I haven't really seen that one. And the challenge as a magician.
You get that now when you say sign a card.
Yeah, they do.
Oh, I've seen this one.
I've seen that. That's the thing. As a magician, it's your challenge to show them that you're going to be doing something different. And I think if you open by just going, hey, you see, everyone knows what a Sharpie pen is. And if you go, boom, and visually, and the way you do that change, that would work for a big table.
Yeah, well, that's different because it's all down here before. I do try and get everything up if you can.
Yeah.
And I do like that sort of change.
Because my one negative I was thinking about this is it might only work in a very close quarters situation.
Yeah.
But if you were doing the change up here like you did, I think that would work for a banqueting tile table, you know, and kind of seven or eight people around.
Because people are so focused on the words as well, I don't think they can see what's going on. I really like it. I want to play around with it. I'm going to give it 92%.
Yeah, but it's a worker. I think it's definitely a worker. I'm going to use it, I think, 93%.
Better than Turbo Stick.
It's as good as Turbo.
A lot better than Turbo Stick.
It is better than Turbo Stick.
John?
It is remarkable.
It's remarkable.
It's the final word. Okay, so next up, now you've finished your McFlurry, is Delicious Ambitious by Alexander De... no, not Alexander De Kova. Alexander Kolle. And here's a bold statement. The ambitious card that fools magicians. You will be fooled. You'll be fooled. Everybody at home will be fooled. Basically, what happened...
That is a bold statement.
It is a bold statement, isn't it? It's probably in brackets underneath, although not if Craig Petty performs it.
Yeah.
What you have here
Why did you pick this up, Craig, this product?
I'll tell you exactly why I picked this up. This basically is a way of allowing you to do a DL without a get ready. So all of you guys that say my get ready is not really ready, then... This is just awesome for me. In fact, I'm going to perform it first of all, and then we'll go into the whys and wherefores. I opened it up about 15 minutes ago. I can kind of do it already. John, get it off this list.
Kind of doing it. Kind of allowing yourself for a little bit of a mess up.
Well,
there.
Exactly, yeah, because I'm not 100% confident. So you're going to pick a card for me, Dave?
Yep.
Grab one out. Doesn't really matter which one.
Okay.
And sign it on the face. Doesn't matter whether I see it. There you go.
Okay. Done.
Cool. So we're going to put that card down into the middle of the... Oh, whoops. I'm going to put that card down into the middle of the... Oh, about halfway. That's fair.
It's amazing. Stop that. Just hold the cards a bit tighter, then it won't push one out.
Is that what I need to do?
Yeah. Oh, won't push one out. Look untidy then.
You think I'd learn, wouldn't you? So anyway, we're not going to take the... we're going to take the Queen of Spades, and that's not your card, obviously.
Definitely not my card.
Although it's a black court card, which was like your card, but this isn't your card.
No.
What are we going to do? I'm going to put the Queen right here, snap my fingers, and when I do, it turns into your card complete with your signature. I'm going to do that one more time. I'm going to do that one more time. I want you to watch very carefully. John, check this out. I'm going to take the card. I'm going to do this really slowly. Look, there it is. It goes down, right down into the middle of the deck. All the way in.
Yeah.
There it is. All I have to do is snap, and when I do, it comes right to the top of the deck. There it is.
Yeah.
And that's it, basically. You've got that sequence, and then there's another sequence at the end that's very, very hard that I'm not even going to bother to try and do. But basically, what it allows you to do...
is put a card in the middle of the deck. It's not on the top, but then you click, and then it comes on top. And then you put the card about halfway. It's not on the top, but then you click and then it jumps on top. So you put it about halfway like that, and then you click and then it jumps on top.
Yeah, basically, this like that. Yeah. Yeah. What? That's a very good point.
What's the difference?
There is no difference.
Apart from you've got a D beer in there.
You got a gimmick D beer. Yeah, that's the thing. This comes with.
And you could use a D beer with any deck to make it the trick that fooled Houdini. So
yeah.
They're saying it's a trick that fools magician. The adding of the D beer as legend goes, you know, Houdini sat watching it for hours and couldn't work it out.
Yep.
He'd obviously never been in a magic shop before and seen what trick cards were available at the time. He was busy
out in
the Hudson River and that kind of stuff, making a name for himself. He wasn't bothered about the ambitious card. And if he'd have gone into a magic shop and seen that D beers were available, he'd have gone, oh, yeah, that's it. But this just is like the stuff of legends now because it's the trick that fooled Houdini.
Yep.
Is it going to fool me? No, because I actually don't think it's as clean as using just a D beer.
There are so many techniques to be able to use in an ambitious card now. Wesley James add-ons, millions. Come on, I've seen a billion different ambitious card routines that just use a regular deck of cards, and they have some amazingly creative, brilliant sequences in them. And then if you want to get really clever with your gimmicks, you've got stuff like the Hawk, by the same guy. Stuff like Daryl's original tied deck.
Well, that's amazing. That's a gimmick that's worthwhile.
Yeah.
I don't get it. I think, why has this trick been invented? It's been invented for people that don't want to spend 3 hours.
You know what I think it is? I think it's been invented to...
It impresses magicians more than it does. Than it does the public, because they can be on this trade stand and they can say, look, I'm not doing any get ready or any kind, but look, there it is. There's a DL.
Yeah, exactly.
There's a DL. Isn't that great? Because I didn't have to do any more. The only person that thinks it's good is the magician, because they know they didn't see any moves. But if you're doing it right anyway, or above averagely, you're not going to see any get ready anyway.
Exactly.
And if you just put a DB-er in your deck, it's as good, if not better.
I mean, that's the thing, you know, people take the mick out of my my get ready for my DL. And yeah, it's not the best. I haven't actually worked on
Well, the thing is, I'm going to defend you now.
Thank you.
Get ready. Right, I'm going to defend you. In the real world, right, most people know, most workers know, that in the real world, you don't stand here like this, cramped, on a sofa.
No.
Do you? With a camera burning you.
No, you don't.
In the real... And mine's not much better, but I will always say, you know, just hold that out like that. And your hands are all over the place. Then you bring focus back.
Yep.
And then you do it.
Yep.
It's not about being there, people burning it. The only people that watch things like that are the people that comment and go, it's terrible.
Totally.
Work on it.
I completely agree with you.
I'm not making excuses.
No, I agree.
Most of the time, you're making a bigger action.
I'm working.
It's not that bad. Leave him alone.
Thank you. I appreciate that. I go out and I do.
He bought me a McFlurry. He's all right.
Hey.
What?
You didn't buy me one.
Yeah, I know, but...
You weren't here. You snooze, you lose. And that's, yes, thank you, I appreciate that. And yes, I go out.
It is true,
though.
It is true.
You know,
when you've got his hand this big on the screen, you go, oh, it's all right there.
Yeah, it's true.
That's it. And exactly.
The YouTube cyber warriors now in a meeting.
Everything onto you.
Having a meeting in a room with a big, massive sort of 70-inch plasma, frame by frame, watching your get ready going, it's not acceptable. But it's not like that in the real world.
It's not. You know, I've never had anybody stand around.
If it
going,
is, stand behind the person.
Exactly. There you go. There's ways of showing it. But look, back to the original point. There's a reason this has been brought
up. I'm going
to
get so much crap for that.
Yes, you are. Yeah. But I appreciate it.
I'm not logging on to the calf for 2 months now.
There's a reason this has been brought out. Let me tell you why the reason is. I might get some crap for this as well. But this is the reason this has been brought out. Science Friction came out 2 years ago. Which is a great product, great product, fantastic product. This DVD is just one routine off a DVD of multiple routines that came with the DVD that was brought out with Science Friction. The only difference in this is you don't get any Science Friction. What you get is you get some prepared cards.
It's a cheap option.
Yeah, they took one of the weakest routines on the DVD and decided to release it as a single trick. Here's what I suggest you do.
Science Friction's brilliant.
If you like the concept of this, if you like the concept of Science Friction, which is basically without any roughing fluid or sicky stuff or anything like that, allowing you to have multiple cards kind of, you know, then get Science Friction. It's fantastic, and get the DVD. That that comes with it. I don't think anybody should be getting this, because if you're wanting to do an ambitious card,
and
you want it
to be the best for your spectator, just do the best for your spectator.
Daryl's Ambitious Card DVD by L&L Publishing has never
one
been
of the top
beaten.
Five DVDs of all time, as and far as I'm concerned.
And the reason for that is because Ambitious Card is a brilliant trick that every single professional uses. I remember speaking to Leonard Green at a convention, and he'd just done all this knuckle busting stuff, and I went to him, so what do you do when you're actually doing a gig? And he's like, sponge balls, Ambitious Card.
Yeah,
and that's it. It is the reason it's been done by so many magicians, and the reason people go back to it again and again and again, is because it's a brilliant routine. The audience really can kind of get behind.
And you're ready to go. You don't even need the D-beer. You can just do a routine.
Yeah. If you're going to buy something, buy Remarkable. Do that to open your card set, and then do an Ambitious Card with a regular
deck. And get Daryl's Ambitious Card DVD instead. Don't cheat.
Yeah. Exactly, you don't
How much
need
are you going to give it?
I'm not going to rate it, Dave, for the simple reason that I don't think anybody should buy it, and I don't think it should have been released. If you like the concept, get Science Friction. That's a great product. But this is just
there is no point to it, but somebody might find a point, so I'm giving it 15%. So last on this week's show, we've got a product called Reveal, which is being brought out by Vanishing Ink and by Christopher Rawlins. And
Blackpool this year. I went down to the stand and Andy Gladwin showed me this.
Yep.
And I was just blown away. He showed it me and I had no idea how it worked. It was fantastic.
It's pretty cool. Should we try and do it?
Yeah, let's do this.
We've watched the DVD. You know obviously what's going on, but we're going to do it. I'm going to look away in a second, Craig. And I'm going to get you to draw something on the clipboard. So just hold on to it tightly. Draw something. I'm going to look right away. So if you could hold on to it.
Okay.
Turn the
feel free to come
clipboard
around and look
away
at this.
From me.
Now I've got it off the sticks. Oh, it's the ice cream
man. That's what we need. More ice cream.
Matthew! I'm being really artistic here, Dave.
Okay, and when you've finished, put the pen down. Just hold on to the clipboard with both hands, but just hold it against your chest.
Hang on.
Yep, got that.
Sorry, what did you say, Dave? I was concentrating on
the pen down
on
when you've done it.
Yeah.
And hold on to the clipboard against your chest so
got
I can't
it. Yeah,
see
yeah,
anything.
Yeah, yeah, done.
And there's nothing inside the envelope as well.
No, nothing.
John, it's face the other way, yeah?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
We're going to put it inside the envelope like that. And you can see that, can you, John, there?
Yeah.
And that's going right inside the envelope. And I want you to hold on to that as well.
That's just ridiculous. I didn't put the top on the pen.
All right, okay, I'll do that now. So, that's the situation we're in.
That's fair.
Now, at any point in my show now, and Chris has got a great live performance on the DVD, where he kind of does a routine. I think it was going to be a chair test or something, but he didn't have permission to explain that on the DVD. He then went back to it, and the reaction of the spectator pretty much said it all. The strengths of this are that the image is big enough for people to see.
Yep.
Actually at the back of a small room, so 100 people could see what you've
this
drawn
has been
right
designed
now.
For a stage type environment.
And I know we're going to talk about other Peak devices in a second, but this is a nice stage effect.
Yeah.
And you can of course use a marker pen as well.
Yes, you can.
Which I think is a selling point of it as well. But at any point in the routine, with a time delay, this is what they remember. You remember that you wrote something, I've never looked at it. You've drawn something, it was the other way all the time, and then it's gone in the envelope, you've been holding the envelope all the time.
Totally fair.
Clear your mind, think of it. It was a playing card, wasn't it?
Yep.
Ace of Hearts.
Yes, it was. Ace of Hearts.
Were you drawing the front of the Uprising cover by any
chance? No, I wasn't. I did a really good picture. It was awesome.
And, here we go. So, Ace of Hearts in there. So, cool.
I love it. Look, I've got a Mindbuster Mini, and if I ever have the need to peak something, that tends to be what I use.
Yeah.
But those things are like ridiculous, like £1,500. They're incredibly expensive.
It's brilliant. But like I said, you can use a big thick pen. So you ask somebody
yes,
to draw
you can,
something
yes.
while you're looking the other way. I think that's a strong point.
It is a strong point. I was going to say
if you want everybody to know what they've drawn.
Well, I don't do stage mentalism, you see.
Yeah.
I use the Mindbuster when I'm doing close-up. I don't do any mentalism on stage. I know you do.
Yeah.
So you're in a better situation to talk about the technical side of these things from a stage mentalist point of view than I am. But all I can say is, I've seen a lot of Peak devices, and I think that outside of the Mindbuster, that is the cleverest and best Peak device I've ever seen, especially for a stage room, especially when it's such a big
thing. That's what I'd say. I'd say for a stage presentation, you know, I still like things like a Cornelius pad. I think he's genius.
Yeah, yeah.
And, you know, Mark Paul was on the greatest mentalists or something program, and the whole program started with, you know, him using a Cornelius. It's a very strong device, but it doesn't pop sometimes to the back of the room. A Mindbuster won't, because you can't use a nice thick pen. And I think if you want to do this style of routine, you want it to be visible in a large room, I think this is fantastic. And for a large Peak device, a Peak of a large drawing, I think this is the best available.
And completely different in technique to anything I've ever seen before.
And it's bulletproof. You're not relying on anything as well.
No electronics, nothing to worry about. You know it's going to work.
Yeah.
And when you get the actual Peak of the information, you just wouldn't think it. It's just impossible. I sat there just trying to work it out after Andy showed it me. Yeah. And I was like, is it this?
Well, when you sort of backtrack and tell them what happened, and you describe exactly what happened, remember, I didn't look, you were holding it against your chest, then it's gone into the envelope.
Yeah.
You can't see through the envelope. There's no way, and they're holding on to it. I do think this is very good.
It's a very clever item. Chris Rawlins, if you're watching this, you're a genius, man. This is just a genius way of getting the information that you need for a stage show.
For a stage presentation, absolutely. Not close up.
Yeah, table hoppers, you're not going to carry that around in your pocket. You're better off with a center tear or something like that. But if you're a stage mentalist or we always talk about the close-up guys that want to add themselves a 15-minute cabaret show. You know, that's a perfect thing. Look, that's all it takes in terms of size. You can put yourself a little case together, put that inside the case, and start offering a cabaret show.
And it's a great finale or something to gain information during a larger routine. But he actually uses it as a finale. He goes back to it, just the guys left on the stage, and he reveals the information, reveals what the guy's drawn, and the reaction of the guy on the video says it all. It's really good, really strong. It's nicely made. It's going to work. It's not going to let you down.
The other thing is, it's going to last forever. No refills. It's very
sturdy. You just put a piece of A4 paper, A5 paper on there.
A lot of impression pads and stuff, they need refills constantly.
Yeah.
That's it. It's a one-time investment. It's going to last you forever. Typical Vanishing Ink quality, really. I'm going to give this 92%. I think this is absolutely brilliant. And like I said, Chris Rawlins, you're a genius.
I'm going to give it 94%. I think it's really that good. That's it this week for the Wizard product review. It's been a good week, really, hasn't it? We didn't really like Delicious Ambitious. Both agreed on that. Even me. And I don't really go overtime. Overboard with practicing slights and that kind of thing, but I really think you need to put the effort in to learn a decent, ambitious card routine. Reveal's excellent, remarkable, we absolutely love. Don't forget to follow us on Twitter at @officialWMS. We'll be having some special offers tweeted out very soon, so make sure you follow us on Twitter and also on Facebook and the YouTube channel, which is youtube.com/worldmagicshop. Until next week, we'll see you then, 12 o'clock on a Wednesday. I'm Dave.
I'm Gray.
See you next week.